Next up is Nikhil Kumar, co-founder of Setu and now Pine Labs.
Thank you so much. I hope you're having a good day. We've been talking about how AI is going to impact various different industries. I'm going to talk about AI and financial services, trying to bring two of the biggest buzzwords together, and let's see where we get today. We all know that India doesn't have enough doctors for our population scale, but I hope you guys also know that for a population of 1.4 billion people, we only have 1,300 registered investment advisors as per SEBI. And this is actually a state of affairs. While we have claimed victory on so many things that we have done on financial services, but we do have a long way to go. The thing that I wanted to talk about is the good news is that all the public digital infra that's needed to solve this problem has already been put in place. 2009, we started Aadhaar. Aadhaar led to giving a bank account to everybody. And now that everyone has bank account, we gave them UPI. So people have been using UPI. So this is that moment in India where Indians are more data rich than they've ever been, right? Especially financial data. And we're going to talk about how we're solving this problem. I'm very proud to announce and unveil Sesame. This is the first large language model built for domain-specific use cases for financial services. We worked with, this started as a research project almost 6 months ago with Sarvam, where we were just curious that now that everybody is using LLMs, how do we use this LLMs responsibly in the financial services space? So what we did, we picked up the most hardest problem in financial services, which is providing credit to everybody. As you know, India is an underserved market when it comes to access to credit. And we picked the hardest problem and we said, how do we use LLMs responsibly to make this happen? And what came out of this is, as you all know, if one is giving credit, the most important thing that you try to understand about a borrower is their ability to pay, their intent to pay, right? Ability to pay is actually determined by the income of the user. And the only way to know the real source of income, as somebody said, the real money is what's in your bank account, right? So because of the account aggregator framework, this data is now unlocked. And what we try to do is, how do we make more meaningful sense of this data? And how do we help in credit underwriting? To give you a sense, when we started with the traditional models of building NLP, ML-based models, we were able to categorize up to 60% of the transactions of a user in a bank statement. If you all think about for a moment, what does your bank statement look today? 80% of your transactions are most likely going to be UPI transactions. And how do we construct a person's financial life from their bank statement so that they get access to the right financial products? So when we started, we were at 60%, and I'm very super proud to announce that we have achieved 90%+ of categorization with 86% of accuracy. So what does the stack look like, right? If you look at India, as I said, we have a very, very robust digital data infrastructure. All of that is called out in the data ingestion pipeline. So rather than using this data that we are already getting, we built an LLM which essentially enriches this data and pushes this into a secure user data vault. And then on top of this user data vault, you have app-specific LLMs which can now solve for various different problems. So I'm going to give you a very quick experience of what this is like. Please pray for me. We are going to be doing a live demo and we'll see how we do. Let's go. This is a real-life use case. What is happening right now for the demo is I've connected a user's bank account using account aggregator, and then through the user's consent, we're now basically going to ask, what does my financial life look like? Behind the scenes, what's happening is essentially people are, there is an LLM, which there is a infrastructure which is going and pulling the user's bank statement, and this user's bank statement is fetching data from the bank life, and then enriching this bank statement transaction to categorize every transaction. So what do I mean by categorization, right? So all of you will remember in your bank statement, you'll see something called a narration. It doesn't say what you spend for, etc., right? So we are adding more context, enriching that data by categorizing it as, was this an expense? Was it a food delivery? If it was food delivery, was it Swiggy, etc., etc., to give a user their life. So I just want to ask you, picking up from Bala's thing, how many of you find Bangalore super hot? How many of you bought an AC recently? Okay, so let's say that to the LLM and see what happens. This is a real life use case. We are part of the Pine Labs group, and one of the things that we do is we enable people to make consumer durable purchases at a Croma store or a Reliance store. As you can see, we threw a conversation which was happening in financial services. We don't make financial decisions by talking to our banker in our real life, but what if you could? So as soon as you said that, you know, it's so hot in Bangalore, it understood your context, and it basically came back and recommended and said, hey Nikhil, it looks like it's super hot, do you want to buy an AC, right? So we're going to show you how an AC buying experience is being reimagined using the power of DPI, the AA data which is coming, which gives the financial life, and then putting it to a real life use case where you want to make a purchase decision. My colleague Vinay is typing. If you're wondering who's typing, is Vinay.ai. And what's interesting here is it's not just about saying I want to buy an AC, it's also contextual. Making a purchase is not a very simple decision. It needs to understand what's your room size, what's your budget, and then basis that, you know, Vinay just picked a LG branded AC. So we're going to quickly go through the demo, and I want to wrap up very soon. I know I'm running out of time. Okay, so what it did at this point in time, it made an API call to the Pine Labs backend, from where it fetched offers in real time to understand that these are your ABC bank accounts that you've connected, and for those bank accounts, these are the relevant offers that are available. And and as consumers, what do we want, right? As Bezos says, I want the best price and I want it fastest time delivered. It understands that context, and then now it's going to make recommendations on where you can purchase this from, what is the breakup of the price, and how fast it can get delivered. Just to wrap up, it ends the conversation by sending you a payment link, which you can click on and complete a payment and make this purchase instantly. And this is how we reimagine how financial services and commerce is going to be in the future. Very quickly, just to wrap up, what does this mean? All of us, you know, get that call. Sir, personal loan beka, are you interested? I just got an LIC call this evening. Hopefully, by having more insights about the user, we're going to have more relevant financial products being recommended. Pratyush showed you the power of multilingual and multimodal experiences. So any user can be onboarded to a financial service in any different language. It could be voice, it could be using text, it could be using a combination of both. India will also have, as we know that, you know, we don't have trusted financial advisor. Anybody who you go to is selling you some product. So hopefully people will be able to interact with AI and be able to get relevant financial advice, and also a hyper-personalized relationship manager. At last, I just want to say that India has shown the way on DPI, on how we can lead the world. And we are super committed to build responsible, compliant, secure and safe AI application in the BFSI sector, and I'm looking forward to all of you in joining this journey. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Nikhil.